holding out a bit, but also finding a date and everything was not that easy.
Was it harder for you guys, and this is kind of a question for everybody collectively for World Cup, but did it change at all being easy to schedule games, or has it kind of been consistent in terms of getting in touch with your opponents and making sure that your guys get your games in?
I think we had very few problems scheduling our games. I think there was some problems with the match with the Australians because of the huge time gap, but so far I have not encountered any big problems. Went pretty smoothly to this point.
All right. Well, Valdor, how about you tell us about yourself?
Yeah, of course you can. I started Warhammer when I was about 16. I got into the tabletop and started collecting Blood Angels and later on Grey Knights. And I think 1 year later, the Horus Heresy book series started and got me hooked on that storyline, and I collected them ever since. I'm at the Siege of Terra storyline at the moment. I'm up to date. And I'm curious how they will go from there on, because they already have changed some pretty big storylines. And yeah, I like it. The game itself, I think I played for 2 years now. I got into it when the Eastbound 5 expansion came out. I think it was during the time the Salamanders got into the game. And that actually was a pretty bad start, because I was playing event a lot, and the event games were Salamander mirrors, and they took like half an hour each. So you really needed a lot of time to actually finish one game. But I'm hooked since then, and I really like it. And I like it the way it is. I hope the next week will bring some new stuff, but I don't think that will change.
Yeah, I think whatever we've got coming next week, or again yesterday, if for anybody who's listening to the podcast when it comes out, there's been some interesting stuff. Mind, I know the teasing, the teasers on Facebook from Everguild, this is not the end, this is the beginning, or it's been 3 years, it's time for something to change. It's kind of vague. We don't have really any clue as far as what that could be. The files that were data mined, I think, hint at a mode that's... I don't know Hearthstone. I haven't played Hearthstone, but I know some of the players who've looked at it said it's very similar to something in Hearthstone, where it's a campaign type mode where you're playing against the AI and you get progressive rewards. I don't know what the rewards are going to be, like if they're going to be, card backs or gold or exclusive cards that you can only get through this mode or not.
Well, hopefully the letter.
Yeah, I would like to see exclusive cards that you can only get by beating the mode, right? And that gives you reason to replay it or to play it and gain those things.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I like that too. I mean, some solo mode is a nice addition. You don't have to play it, you can play it, and... You also don't have to schedule some games with some opponents or something like that. I think that would be a fine addition.
Right. And if it's a good way to get cards or gold to players who are new,
Sure.
You mentioned one of the things is, when you came in the game and it was a long games in the event mode, which sometimes those can be a pain. I know the Vulcan and the Mortarian events are probably the prime examples of that. But
oh, dude, I especially loved the event where you had Khan and
Mortarian
available. Yes. Oh, I hate this event.
Some of those events are just like, well, if you're a new player and you get your tickets, that's just not something that you're gonna be happy to see. And the drafting has not. I mean, that's you can play a draft as a new player, although. With gems being limited, and sometimes there are just some drafts where you run up against that wall where better drafting is definitely the better solution, or having some experience and knowledge as far as which warlords are the prime, prime decks options to go with. But if you've got a solo mode that can be maybe a little bit more positive for a newer player to kind of step into and at least get more comfortable with their own understanding of the game.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, the drafting you mentioned earlier for the event, I think that's a better way to go with the event than it was before, because there always was one or two decks that were seriously overpowered and everyone went with them.
Mm-hmm.
If you haven't gotten them in your choice, then you're already screwed. And now you can't have one overpowered deck. You can craft them, of course, if you have enough gems, and some of the older players do. You still can craft a very formidable deck, but everyone can do it.
Right.
Before that, you had the choice or you didn't have it. And if you didn't have it, you're screwed.
Yeah, I think, I mean, I'd like to see it improve a little bit where it's, you can still spend gems, but maybe it's on par so that even though a player may have, you know, a lot more gems, they can only spend so many, you can only do so many rerolls. I know we've talked about that on the podcast before, you know, limiting it to three rerolls per run could be fair and still allow for a lot of options.
Mm.
Yeah, but it's what we've got for right now anyways. Axel, you've taken a look at the mind stuff as well. Is there anything that you had seen that looks interesting?
Besides the fact that we have
one side question.
Yeah,
we had a very important topic before we started the stream with a German team. What's about getting lit? Are we getting drunk and then having fun, or just talk?
Yeah, that's the point.
You can get drunk.
Okay,
if
so
if wants to get wasted, go ahead.
Okay, because that's the point. Like, we're starting off like really tame. We're having a little chit-chat, and then we go full retard. That's the plan, okay?
That's the plan.
That's how you guys want to roll. That's how you want to roll.
I mean, I wasn't lying when I said that it will be three Germans insulting each other after 10.
No insulting. We love each other. We have nice consensual sex, but metaphorically only. You know what I mean?
Scott, can you please edit that out?
Yes, so many.
Scott, you now need to edit that into the intro.
I need to edit out that part where they asked me to edit out that part about mental sex with each other. You know, it's okay.
Oh my god.
No, it's okay. I'll cut that out.
Ooga, booga.
We've got Bar Knight Legions following this. I don't know if you guys are going to be coherent or, you know, awake.
I'm half through my first cocktail, so I'm fine for now.
All right.
But I didn't eat that much. I had a banana in the evening and only breakfast so far. So we'll see.
This midnight is a tough guy. I just finished my next beer, so just saying.
Hey, that's how you want to do it. But you asked me if I found anything interesting in data mining.
Yes.
And I did, actually. I did find some cool things. Particularly, there's interactions between, I want to say, all the Imperial Fist Warlords, Whisper to Robbo, in like lines and such. That, and we have an Iron Circle event warlord coming out soon, which I'm assuming he's going to be part of the new mode, which is dubbed Campaign by the devs.
Mm-hmm.
More things in the code that I found to be interesting was, Camba Diaz. He's confirmed 100%. There was something else in there in the code. I'm trying to remember it off the top of my head, but I can't. Ah, shoot.
If I may interrupt, I think the physics teacher found some interactions with the emperors. I guess there will be storyline or some interaction with him. Or with
those interactions. Those interactions are old though. They were like on launch. They were in there. Each warlord. Some of them were even in there before the Primarchs were. They've been planning on giving us Big E for a while. So I wouldn't be surprised. I'm trying to remember the exact. Oh yeah, no, it's all good. I'm trying to remember what was the key thing I learned, but I can't remember it right off the top of my head. Oh yes, this isn't data mine, but the devs very recently have been talking to the moderators before updates and the tournament organizers so they don't break tournaments. There's an update coming to a faction soon. They said it's only minor, but they just wanted to check to make sure it wouldn't break World Cup. So that does mean we're getting a faction, like something's happening to their cards soon, though it's only going to be small.
I think they posted that on the Discord this morning. Zacharias, who's the tournament organizer for World Cup, shared that information too. So it looks like it won't be anything to disrupt the tournament, which is good. No major update, although it could be significant enough to change a few cards. I don't know if that's going to be Imperial Fists or if it's going to be Orphans of War or some sort of dark horse like Night Lords that nobody, you know, nobody's seen an update for a while.
I'm thinking if we do see a Night Lord change, it will be wider across the board than what they're describing.
I think that's fair, yeah.
Because right now, Night Lords, they need a bit of juice.
They need something. They would need to address the Warlords as well as the troops and like have a strange counterbalance. Like they wait, very similar to how they did the Iron Hands recently, but I don't know. I don't know if they could do it in one go. I think they might require like two patches.
Yeah, likely.
Well, I also could imagine some nerf to the Knights. They are still pretty strong.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Like yeah. Knights are not allowed in the World Cup, that wouldn't disrupt the tournament. I think they might have hinted to that.
That's actually a very fair point.
That is, that's true. Knighthouses, Sisters of Silence, Agents of the Sigillet, and all the new neutrals aren't allowed. So if they were to make changes to any of those, it would not affect the cup whatsoever. And Knights, I mean, I think there's three or four cards that could lose the cantrip effect and be fine.
Yep, yep. I think that's exactly what I'm always saying, dude. Nerf Knights, no one knows how without destroying the faction. I say remove the cycle on fucking most of their cards because the reactor draws itself, the House Macabius, the shield. Like, just remove that. The problem with Knights is the goddamn consistency. They are so consistent because they draw the whole deck by turn 10. They always have the cards they need, and that's why they win so much. And
they have no downside to playing those cards. It's just cool.
They can vomit. They can vomit their hand. They can play like the last retard. And that's the and that's all. That's the problem. Like Plasma Generation also maybe tune that down a bit, so you have to think a bit before firing your weapons. But I think the main point is the cantrip, first of all, and second of all, maybe the Plasma Generation. So we have to think a bit before firing your weapon. And third thing, what I find really awkward is that if you stun the knight, that the weapons aren't stunned. So there would be some counterplay. There would be some counterplay. I mean, that means that there will be a shitload of Alpha Legion on the ladder, which I don't really miss, but still. I still will always fight Alpha Legion over Knights, to be honest.
Yeah, Knights are just not fun to fight. It's fighting an uphill battle.
It's a chore. It's a chore. It's a fucking chore. It's not playing a game. It's making you the fucking dishes for me. Like, seriously, it's a chore. And you always have to perform...
Oh, no, you're 100% right.
And you always have to perform mental somersaults if you're playing a troop deck to somehow outsmart and beat them, while they are just ooga booga, me fire the laser, in this meta.
Bad that they added that the what was it called, the flame cannon at launch, thinking that would.
Oh yes.
I
love Everguild. Holy shit! I mean, I sometimes wonder if they play the game themselves. I sometimes wonder. Do they like, in Magic, I remember in Magic Arena, sometimes you face players with a golden name. These were admins or staff of Wizards of the Coast. And here, I swear, no one from Everguild plays this game. They are like looking at numbers. They have their analytics of different statistics from the game. How much is something picked? How much wins something? And they're like, this looks pretty bad. And sometimes probably they also read social media, so Reddit, Discord, and so on. So that's why they are in hand. So maybe in the end they listen to Mortem. Mortem!
Yeah, it's all Iron Mortem's fault.
It's all Iron Mortem. Mortem.
Well, I'm not sure, because I think before I had joined the Discord, there used to be an Everguild employee who played, who was on the Discord. But that was like beta.
Was he toxic? Was he toxic and salty when you GG him? Like, GG employee, and he's like, fuck you, RNG! Ah!
No, I never talked to him. Like, I think somebody had mentioned him like in passing, like, hey, he hasn't played for like, you know, like 6-7 months. And then he like responded. He's like, yeah, but I'm still here, but I'm not really, you know, like.
Yeah, fuck this game. I hate the game, but I get money for it. So yeah.
Yeah, and I'm not really sure. I mean. I'm sure to some degree they're like, hey, does this card do what it's supposed to do? You'd like to think that that's what they do, but then we have Fafnir Ran on release hours. Yeah, so I don't know how much they actively play their game, and we've asked time and time again, hey, you know, could maybe have a closed team, like have like five or six really good players, like who are willing to beta test a faction or a card or a mechanic.
What we need is a public test beta.
Yeah.
Where it's just open it up. Some people can join. Here's a new faction that's coming out. You can just test them out for a bit. Is there any problems? It would very much so help.
It would be nice to get stuff on release that isn't either, you know, non-functional or overly powered. Because, yeah, the flame cannon, it was probably the worst.
That was a joke. How much energy did it cost again?
Two.
The plasma.
Yeah.
How much energy, fire it once and you can fire it every time again when it kills something.
If you kill somebody, it does 2 damage to the entire board. If it kills a unit, you can fire it again.
Sorry.
But how much was it to play? Was it 4 energy?
4. It was still 4.
Yeah. Which, if you look at that compared to artillery or any of the salamander cards, you go, huh, what the fuck?
Regarding the employee, I have some guy in the chat saying Phaedros doxed him. Like, whatever that means.
Oh. So dox is where you drop someone's address and, like, their real name and stuff.
Okay. Is that what you mean, Altharius Omegon? I'm talking to someone in the chat, so, yeah.
Oh, that's all good.
Midnight is streaming while we're chatting here, so...
Yeah, so that means, even if we were to edit that out, that those words are still transcribed on the internet. You guys can't escape consensual sex mentally.
They're out there somewhere. You guys, see, I can edit it out, but Midnight can't edit out his true desires.
I'm not getting any money for it, so who gives a shit? When this gets monetized someday, then I have to take care. Because last stream, I was listening to music on YouTube, and you know how many strikes I got? I was simply listening to my YouTube mix, and I got like eight of those strikes while it's demonetized. I was like, okay, I don't give a shit, it's not monetized anyway. But if it would have been, holy crap, you have to be really careful.
Yes, was it a year or two ago, they changed that, and that's kind of, it didn't change, I'm not monetized either, I had enough subs to even monetize, but like it's like, okay, well, that makes it less fun to mix music in or to have something playing in the background. You've got to find something that's free, or you know, have you can't even if you own it yourself or you're playing to it, it's in your house, that doesn't count. That's not allowed.
Pass by someone playing it on the street and you can get
right. Well, and there was a big thing, and this is completely unrelated to Horus Heresy Legions, but Twitch. If I recall correctly, when that took place, when there was a, I know, when there was a change to the copyright protection for music, there was several Twitch users who had their videos retroactively striked and they were banned for like stuff that they had put out like 4 or 5 years ago that other people had copied over and dubbed music to, but because it was their source material, they got held accountable. It took them like, 6 months of like, I didn't even know that I had to go back and fix those videos until the day of. It's a whole mess. I don't do Twitch. I'm not,
copyright in itself.
Fuck Twitch. Don't do Twitch.
Yeah. Don't do Twitch.
Unless you are like Scuff, you will wear a bikini and then go into a hot tub. And then, yes!
Hey, I'm just saying, Scuff,
shut the fuck up. You wear a bikini, you go into the hot tub, and then you lick the fucking microphone for money. You understand me? That's what you do.
Yeah.
That's what you do. Then you get rich. And that's how you will make a living, okay? Fuck your job.
That's how you
will sit
Twitch.
In the goddamn bathtub for 8 hours. You will get drunk, and then you will lick the microphone for money, okay? This is what you're gonna do.
That's what they do on Twitch.
Are you gonna be like?
Yeah, that's why fuck Twitch. But you're not allowed to use swear words. You're not allowed to listen to the music you want. But it's okay to show tits, show ass, and lick the microphone to money. That's quality content. That's what Twitch promotes. That's why I fucking hate Twitch. Fuck Twitch.
I mean, that's
fair.
I'm there.
No.
That's fair.
That's spoken right to the YouTube.
That's right. See, he's, like YouTube is signing Midnight. Midnight for a contract right now.
I don't think YouTube gives a shit. They have enough money. They don't give a shit about Twitch.
No, they'll just hire you to run a Twitch smear campaign. It'll work.
Yeah, I like some music now.
Talking about the Imperial Fists, that's the topic we'll get to here shortly. Before we do, now that we've done player introductions, I want to talk about Team Germany in the World Cup. You guys, right now, based off of the standings that are shown there, you guys are in third in the group stage? But B-side, you said you still have your game to do.
Yeah, I think our last two games are still, like, all the whole play day isn't scored yet.
Okay, so are you guys looking to advance into the top cut, or are you on the bubble?
No, we're... Yes, it's looking good. I texted with Big Pippi today, with my homie Big Pippi, and it's looking quite good for us, because Vapix is memeing. It's kind of, even if, I don't remember correctly, but even if Italy or someone makes enough points, they still don't make it, so we're actually pretty safe.
Italy's out, they already have played all their games, but our direct opponents are Australia, Balkans, and Spain, and Balkans are facing Spain, and Australia is facing Asia. And even Asia is completely out of the hot ground, and they will take each other's points. So there are some combinations where we lose and we drop out of the top four, but they are highly unlikely. It still could happen. Mm.
Okay. Because it's we talked about this when Vapix was on Power Mother World Cup. Like, your guys' group is very tight. I mean, like, it like points or two. I mean, Germany's right now has got 105 points. And third, based off of just the image I'm looking at, and Australia, you mentioned, is at 102 points, which is 3 points behind you at fourth. But Italy is at fifth with 100 points. So, I mean, just within the three of you guys, there's only a five-point difference, or, you know, 2 to 3 points.
You have to consider that Italy already has played each of its games.
And they're all the way done, right?
Yep. But okay. If you think from spot one to spot seven, everyone could make the cut.
Right, because Balkans hasn't played, right?
I'm sorry?
The Middle Europe and Balkan Miners hasn't played?
They haven't played yet, no.
And Spain is playing...
Balkans,
okay. Yeah, so depending on how that goes.
Australia is playing Asia, we are playing France, and if you consider our last two games, which are already played but not included in the standings, we would have 111 points. So that's... bit more than you can see actually now, but it's still close.
It's gonna be kind of tooth and nails. I mean, I think spots eight and nine are probably locked. I think the Isles and Kazakhstan are probably not advancing. France is most likely still going to advance.
Yeah, of course, France, they won every round, like Asia. So these are France and Asia are safe, like 100%
safe. France actually first for sure. No one can topple them anymore.
Well, it'll be interesting to see.
But yeah, it is pretty interesting. And as I said, Italy is out, but this game between Spain and Middle Europe is very interesting, obviously, for us as well. Because
Go ahead.
Are they? Because they both have to beat each other pretty decisively to pass us, but they could.
I mean, with the standings now, let's say let's say you score 0 points, then Balkans would win if they win 18-9, and Spain would be at the same spot with us when they win 21-6. Both are highly unlikely, but they are possible. It's still a game based partially on. So bside, you have to draw us out of the dirt if that happens.
No pressure, though,
bro. You're fine. Like, no pressure, yeah? You're good, man.
Yeah, no.
You
fuck it
up.
So the guy I'm playing. Yeah. I know that. That's what I'm afraid of. But the guy who I'm playing is already had made some theories why he needs to 3-0 me. So I will try to not get 3-0'd. Because, I mean, we're playing France, so they're the strongest. Because they already advanced this first, obviously that's kind of the strongest in the group, even though Asia would say no because they beat France, but whatever. It's gonna be a tough game. But since it, and it apparently it doesn't matter that it doesn't, the game doesn't matter for France anymore, so it will be fought out until the last drop of blood.
Now, which warlords are you guys playing?
Should I start?
Yeah, yep. Go ahead. You go ahead and start, yeah.
I'm playing Nykona. I don't know, that's my favorite warlord simply. I have... that's the first warlord I ever hit the 50 with. I really like, as mentioned, the Raven Guard playstyle. That's why, yeah. And yeah, what else to say here, to be honest? I don't know. I just really like him. Currently, he's not that good in current in simple ranked play, but I don't know. I kind of felt obliged to pull Raven God.
Yeah.
Sorry, I'm playing besides. That's why I'm a bit unfocused. So anyway, I originally had Escalon because it's also one of my highest win rate warlords, although he's kind of off meta, but I really enjoyed him and so on. But I changed him to Branson early because all my warlords were like combo and damage oriented. So yeah. What else? Then I have Branson as mentioned, just like my control warlord, also one of the first warlords I made to 50 with alongside with Nykona. And my last warlord is Rom. I think I have about 600 or 700 games with Rom. He's like one of both the warlords who can cheese it out really easily. Because of his stupid damage output. Holy shit, I just wrecked that Dawn so hard. Fuck my life. I'm playing Draeger. anyway. So, yeah. These are my warlords. I don't know, I should have picked differently because they share a similar weakness from time to time. I should have thought it a bit better through. But Desperate Defense was such a mess during the start of the World Cup. And these three warlords, they all aren't out the loss against Desperate Defense. That's why I picked them. Kind of. That was my thought behind it. Like, I wanted a high win rate. I know, so warlords I'm confident with. And warlords who don't auto lose to Desperate Defense. That was kind of my point. I didn't think about, didn't really think it through that Desperate Defense after 6 or 7 months might finally be patched. I don't know. I'm kind of disappointed with my picks now, but it still works. I won 5 of my rounds and lost 3. Could have been 6 to be honest, because I misplayed one heart. But yeah, I'm still really happy with my results. And also, what I noticed is that almost no one plays the warlords I picked. So I'm a special snowflake. You know what I mean?
Really stands out among the crowd.
Yes, that's very important for me. I need attention.
You get a breath of fresh air when people place you.
What?
They said you're like a breath of fresh air when your opponents face you. They
yes.
You know.
They like they like le autism. They like to chat with me. They like le autism. They like the brainless playing style of me. They like you know, in our team, bside and Constantin, they are like they are always playing a lot of practice games. They theory craft a lot. Like they're preparing their decks for their matchups. They ask each other, what can I do
and
here, what can I do here?
It doesn't work at all.
No, it's fine, it's fine. It's actually the right thing to do because like the top players, in my opinion, are Rubbus Moon, Spellbreaker and Orthonal in our group. And what they do right is that they win their matches before even the matches start. They tech so good, they tech the deck so good that they have a really easy matchup. Like in all seriousness, that's a kinda is the real margin between a good player like us. Without pushing my ego, I would say like we all three of us are good players. But what
is you guys are in World Cup.
But really the little margin between being a good player and being a really good player is I don't know, it's kind of like a little drop which makes the glass overflow, and then yeah. And this is this kind of thing what I noticed with these guys when I played them. They really just counted me even before the game started. Like in those games I had no chance because it's like when you face a really bad matchup on ladder. So it didn't matter if I played perfectly, I would still lost. That's what they are doing better than us. And yeah, what I wanted to say...
That's the one... I'm sorry.
Yeah, but that's what I basically wanted to say, like, oh, we... B-side and Constantin do they tech, like, for days. And I'm just like, yeah, it's fine, I'm just gonna do it, and it kind of works, you know? I'm not thinking much about it, I'm going to relax into it, I'm just, it's like a game where it's not about money, it's just about a fucking card pack. Like, I'm having fun. I still have a competitive spirit, so to say, but this event is, I don't know, it's more like a friendly competition for me. I don't take it too serious, I don't think too much, I just play my games, and it kind of works, and I'm happy about it. I talked a lot, right?
Hey, that's fine.
It's okay. That's all right. You were going to say something, Constantine?
Yeah, yes. I wanted to enforce Midnight's argument here because if you face those players and you play a certain playstyle, you play some cards, you know, there's one card your opponent could use that would disrupt your playstyle completely, and those top of the top players do have them in their decks. Mm-hmm. And for some reason, they most of the time have them in their hands too. And that's something a good player lacks. They don't think that through, they don't have that one card. And some of the top players, which we have in our group, do have that card.
Make some stiff competition. Well, especially when it's like you said, like it's just one card that can disrupt you. And if they've got that included, that could be all it takes is to break the game.
Yeah, it could be something simple like Sabotage. Anything like that, or some D-stun card by Alpha. Well, you're done. Your plan doesn't go anymore, he can act when you want him not to act, and that's it.
Buddy Rose.
But it's B-side. Also... it's also kind of... It's exactly what they say, but also, like Midnight said, Constantin and I sometimes try to do exactly that. You know, we tech like for days, and we try to make it go. And but doesn't work all the time. And the weird thing is that it seems to be very, pretty like there is a War Master bonus. I think all the people with the War Master card deck, they just can't do this better. I don't know, not better, but they just have like a better luck in some way.
Every guild would have given us the right cards in the right way.
Yeah. But I mean, it's great if you have those games. I mean, I had like in the World Cup also a couple of games where it worked out like a charm, and then games where you have all those cards in your deck and you think, oh, now I would need this, but it's just not coming.
Yeah.
But I think that's just how luck of the draw.
I need to make you guys louder because my stream doesn't hear you at all.
They can't hear you?
They can hear you. Yeah. They say Constantine is super, super, super quiet. But for me it's fine, but I don't know.
They said that they couldn't hear B-side or Valdor.
Huh.
I can concede this game anyway.
Is it better now? I can turn up my mic.
No. Maybe I'll just turn off my music for now. You can turn off the music again when.
Yeah, because I mean, I can hear you guys fine, but if it's coming through on Midnight's audio, that might be a different story.
Yeah, I got an idea.
I'll make that. It's OBS because I got my desktop a bit. I think it's. Try to talk now. It might be better now because I got my desktop audio tuned down. Let's see what the chat says.
Well, we should talk.
Yeah,
right?
Let's just keep talking and then we.
Yeah, just keep talking, and then if it's not working, you'll find out one way or the other.
Yep.
So, getting into then, I guess the faction spotlight side of things. Or actually, well, we didn't hear what Warlords B-side and Valdor have got. What Warlords are you guys running?
I'm running Vulcan, which is actually the same reason that Midnight's playing Nekona. It's just my kind of favorite Warlord, kind of cool lore and works well, and also was the first one who brought me into top 50. Then I have Perturabo because he's just was strong and he was very strong against all this desperate deep defense games, just ended the game way long before. Now it's a little bit of a different situation, but oh well. And the third one is Ahriman because he also is just very strong and we didn't have any Thousand Suns yet. That's about it.
Sei nicht so schüchtern, mein Guter. Erzähl mal ein bisschen mehr hier.
Ja, what else should I say? Well, during the World Cup, I mean, we saw a little bit more. I mean, there's like, for some of these, they're like very much pre-made decks. Like, there's like this Vapix type Ahriman deck that everyone plays, and even if someone comes up with a completely new deck in their mind, it looks 99% like that. But then I've been at least a little bit innovative for both Perturabo, where I have like some two Perturabo decks that sometimes worked and sometimes didn't work, and for Vulcan, where I took some decks that were already around but made them a little bit, streamlined them a little bit for the World Cup. And that,
I need to interrupt you here for a short moment. Scuff, that's exactly how our team meetings go. Something catastrophic happens at midnight. It's like, oh my god, what the fuck? What did now happen? How did that go? And B-side's like, oh.
Yeah, it's always like that. I'm like completely freaking out. I'm like losing
every
my shit,
time.
As usual, at B-side, it's always. It's always.
Yeah, you need a good mixture.
Yeah.
Midnight turns into the Hulk, and B-side is as calm as can be.
I
someone could come to his house and say, I have to execute you now, and he says, oh, shame, haven't finished dinner yet. That's that B-side.
No. B-side, if someone comes to execute, I don't.
We also have a little request from the chat. Johan wants to know, tell us how Mr. Midnight became the captain of Team Germany. Inside sources tell me he's bad at the game.
You say that, I also just got a message from Juan asking the same question. This guy really wants to know.
Really wants to know.
Well, why Midnight became our captain?
Yeah, tell them.
Well, he volunteered and that's it.
Yep.
That was it? There was like,
that was it.
Because I was the only one actively communicating with the rest.
You're also
there,
Mr.
Was, there was no
on,
vote,
on the
there was just
court.
One guy who actually did it.
Yes, like I was the only one actively communicating in the World Cup chat, and that's why, yeah, if no one else wants, I'm already talking to them, so why the fuck not? And that's basically it.
That's fair. I think the captain title was really just to help facilitate, you know, matchmaking sometimes, make sure that the games are moving along.
Yeah, which worked actually pretty good.
Yeah.
So,
I think
more problems,
I would even claim
with different time zones, but it worked quite good. So sorry, B-side.
I would even claim that we are maybe the very German team. We are like always getting our games done in time and so on. So it's I think one time we had to like a problem, but it was on the other side.
Yeah, deutsche Pünktlichkeit.
Exactly.
How about you, Valdor? What warlords are you running?
I'm actually not running my signature guy here because I think he would have been crushed by desperate defense. And I made my warlord choices exactly because of that card. I went with Alpha Legionnaire, which everyone knows now is Exodus, because you can play around desperate defense. I chose Custodes because I wanted to have one of the Custodes warlords. I went with Amon because he could stun one or two of those units. And I went with Gilliman because he's a solid all-rounder. If I knew or had known that Desperate Defense would have been changed, I guess I would have picked something else. Maybe Lucretia, maybe, I don't know, even something like Curse. Something that isn't completely blocked out when Desperate Defense hits the board. Mm. But now, well, I have to go with them. I'm kind of happy, kind of unhappy with the choices I made. Gilliman has not disappointed me so far. Exodus, I don't know. I mean, I've seen some streams with Balgard or Juan with the games, and I was like, I never get those cards with Exodus when I need them. They always have them. I have buried them in my deck deep down, so I got a bit lucky with him. I'm lucky with him. And Amon so far, he most of the time was the first choice in my games. He won, actually, two of those games. But against the Rex Cult, I was completely outplayed. That was what Midnight mentioned earlier with the winning before the game actually started.
Mm-hmm.
He had Mortarion in his roster, and I was, if I start with Amon, maybe I don't run into him, but that was what happened. And Custodes against Death Guard, especially Mortarion, you have no chance.
Yeah, that's a bad match. Like you're.
It's not a bad matchup. It's an auto loss, my friend.
It's pretty much like just count. Take the time.
I was teching against it. I was using lots of neutral cards that could deal damage even when they are stunned, like the Helios Border Carrier or the free Mechanicum guy. I don't know its name, but still, at some point, you're dead.
Yeah.
You might have to play one of the Custodes cards. Most of the time, it's the Hunting Eagle. And that thing gets insta-stunned, and it gets stunned until the end of the game. And you dry out. You have no cards, which is a big issue with Custodes, because they're the only faction that have that. And the stat lines they have is by far not any better than those of the newer legions.
So it doesn't line up with the new cards for sure.
Yeah. Exactly. And the that's Sentinel what Rex called. He used it against me, and he did that very good, and then he won. That's completely fine.
Yep.
Happens to the best of us. I'd love to see if Custodes could get their Sentinel reworked, or at least. As their stat line is no longer as good, especially looking post Blood Angels.
Angels with the Solar Auxilia, if you play Strategic Reserves and you get the 45th section with it, you actually have a better 4-drop than the Lantern Knights of the Custodes. You already had the exact same health pool. It had a higher attack, 4-5, which is huge because then the card can be Melgatored, and you don't have the debuff for Sentinel.
And has an ability, you know?
Yeah, I forgot that. Yeah, you're right.
Yeah. Yeah, the Solar Auxilia is hot to trot at the moment. I got a Shapura Solar Auxilia deck. I'm still missing the Epic, the 2-3 Katsuhiro. Yeah.
Yeah, he's kind of.
But he's nice. But once you hit Maximus on, it's ridiculous. Like
you mean Valerius?
Well, Valerius is nice, but I'm talking like if you're protecting with the front line, Valerius is very good. Yeah.
Yeah.
But Maximus locks it. That's what it's all about.
Maximus.
Yeah.
I know what card you mean.
Maximus.
The legendary.
Marcus.
I call him Maximus.
The Gladiator movie, yeah.
Yeah. I call him Maximus because he hits, he's so gold.
The
gold plate he hits, and like, that's it. Like, you know.
That's what we're running with?
That's what I'm running with. That's what I have to go back through all my posts because I'm pretty sure I've typed up Maximus like a dozen times in the last week.
Poor stuff.
Hey, you know what? I make no apologies. My autocorrect is flubbed as it is. Like, if I mistype a word, I just roll with it.
Maximus.
That's right.
It's a Maximus.
Maximus Valerius.
That's a very good drop.
Okay, from now on, it will be Maximus Valerius.
That's what we'll go with.
My girlfriend actually did something mean to me because when Alpha Legion came out, I wanted to show her the game. And I looked at the cards they had, and I looked at the 10 drop, which usually was bad then and still is a bad drop. And it was the Legion Glaive. And I was like, oh, look at that awesome card. It has frontline. It has a beefy stat line, 10-10, and enemy tactics cost 4 more. And that will never get removed in the turn it comes into the game. And she looked at it and said, that looks like a duck. And I went, what?
Like what?
Yeah, the cannon. It looks like a beak, and the small laser target, it looks like an eye. It's a duck tank. And I was, no. And I looked at that card, and never, from that moment on, I forgot that it looks like a duck. And whenever I see the card, I see, yeah, that's the duck tank.
Which card Jesus looks like a duck? Which card looks like a duck?
The Legion Glaive from Alpha Legion. And it looks like a fucking duck from now on. Until the end of my life.
Too. Okay.
It's a mighty weapon of war, and it looks like
it's a duck. It's not a tank, it's a quack.
That talk about just like total like underselling, you know, you just like look at this badass tank that just is brutal. It's like, yeah, it's like a duck. It's like a, you know, cute little kitty. What? Like,
oh, there's other animal inspired things in this game, right?
There are quite, well, I think Attilan's score, his mask is supposed to be like a lion face.
Yeah, it's a lion, yeah, it looks like
have a nice day. Every time I see it, like, have a nice day.
Really bad. I love
just
it
a
so
smiley
much.
Face. So I see this. I see the smiley face emote when I see Attilan Score's face.
Yeah, that's kind of right.
It's definitely not great.
Well, talking about, I guess at this point we're at the halfway point, or
at
we're
the
a little
halfway
past
point,
the halfway
and it's
point.
Time for another drink, boys. Oh wait, I
get some drinks.
Yes,
I'm already at my second beer.
Second.
Keep up.
Only second. How many is midnight
you
have?
You know the beers I have, Scott.
See, Axel, this is a test for our midnight New Year's Eve party episode. So.
Oh yeah.
Now, granted, for our German friends, for Team Germany, it is evening time where they're at. For me, it is lunchtime.
For Team Germany, this is just everyday life.
That's probably true. I don't know.
Yeah, yeah, I can't disagree with that.
See?
Well, talking about the Imperial Fists, because that is kind of the faction spotlight episode we're supposed to be talking about.
We must prepare for the unthinkable.
I want to talk about a little bit about the... I mean, obviously, from the sounds of it in your guys' background, you may not necessarily be super lore savvy with the Imperial Fist, and that's okay. We don't have to dive too deep into the lore. We can obviously talk about the Warlords. Cards, maybe more... one thing I really want to hear is how you guys feel. What's your take on the Bastion mechanic? And just kind of go around that way. And then... what are your top your favorite cards? So we've got talking Warlords. We'll start with the Warlord side first.
Okay. Because we've, first of all, I'm mixing myself. I started off with an old fashioned like last stream, but yet now I'm mixing for the stream. I'm mixing a gin tonic now. A simple, simple long drink. I have some Mistral gin. This is gin with vegetables. And very important in the gin tonic is of course the tonic. We have Fever Tree. Elderflower tonic water. Elderflower adds a really nice aftertaste to the tonic, and I really love it. So you want cucumber instead of lemon because of the vegetable taste. The vegetable taste goes much better with a gin tonic than a lemon. This is my favorite tonic, and the gin of your choice. I just like this one because, again, it has a celery added in it. Okay, go ahead.
Okay, all right. For all the newer players listening to Scuff's podcast, that is actually not part of the Imperial Fist faction.
No, it's not, but I'll tell you what, it sounds really good.
I'm busy, so the one after me can start with their...
Yeah, go, B-side. So we're talking about we've got four Warlords. We've got Pollux, Sigismund, Dorne, and we're going to be getting Diaz. How are you feeling about the Warlords?
Oh yeah, the Imperial Fists, I've never played them on ladder, I have to admit. They're but events are always kind of fun as soon as you get a hang of it. Because at the beginning the games were also very long, but there's all a lot of pew pew if you play it right. So it's a fun faction. It's like very strong, I find, but it has a little bit boring playstyle because you don't attack, you just like sit there and you try to build up board.
Besides, sorry, how do the turrets make again? Wie machen die nochmal?
Pew pew.
Jetzt nochmal ohne Ton.
Pew pew.
Ohne Ton! Okay, go ahead, sorry.
It's the exact same sound the Graviton cannon makes.
Yeah, correctly, but I think it's a slight different because in the books, sorry that I'm going off topic again. But if I remember, if you fire a Graviton cannon in the books, it's like completely devastating, like heat blow, which fries everything in a couple hundred meters. And I think the turrets are just like pew pew in the books as well. I don't know, but I find it quite funny that they make the same sound.
Yeah, they could ramp up the Graviton cannons.
Yeah,
sound.
I could lay like.
Yeah.
I don't know why Vengeful Spirit gets this cool ass explosion, then Graviton Lance just gets a. Pew.
Yeah, I mean, there are some cool explosions like the Asherax, the 10 drop from Mechanicum. That has
also a unique animation. I don't know why they don't do it for everything. Mm-hmm. Because I don't know. Okay, I don't know. They are lazy. They do be lazy.
More love.
Open this box.
We love EG. We just have only bad words for them.
Yeah, it's a love-hate relationship sometimes.
Yeah, it's a love-hate relationship, definitely. Holy crap.
So, Evergild, if you're listening to this, we love you a bit more than we hate you.
Yes.
That's true.
We will only say horrible things, but we do love you.
We only say horrible things because we want you to be better, baby. Come on.
Yes, get good.
Don't make me hurt you, baby.
Holy shit, the gin is pink. Like I thought only the bottle was pink, but the gin is actually pink.
How about you, Valdor? What's your take on the Veld?
Well, I think the defensive playstyle hurts them a lot when you try to play them competitive because you're getting outplayed. On the other hand, if you're lucky, the Imperial Fists are like an avalanche. If you can drop Kestros and Fortified Outposts on curve, and then give them bastion after bastion, you can fill up.
He's gone. Where did he go?
Really pretty hard to do. And I think since the game is very aggressive, you usually don't have the chance to get to that point where the avalanche can't be held anymore.
Yeah. I think that's fair. I think they see, and I think that's for me, I prefer to play them not so defensive. Dorn is kind of locked. He is based on his ability and his opening hand. He's kind of stuck in that route. But I think
I agree.
I think Pollux and Sigismund are much more flexible than people tend to realize or want to push that way, just because they bank on Kestros or the turrets, or you know, there's not a whole lot of like power troops. Like they come out with like stats, like they've got like, I mean, Gorhagen is a great card, Archimus is a great card to boost your Astartes, but there really aren't any huge like flankers or like, you know, rally effects that are massively powerful for them, that aside from maybe the Whirlwind or Justice, who's a great finisher. So that early game is kind of building up and fortifying more than anything, but they can be offensive. But yeah, like you said, like, I mean, playing that defensive role, especially with the way the ladder can be very aggressive, it's not easy. It works in some matchups more so to your favor. I think obviously if you're facing against like an Angron or even like a Kroll, I think you could do very well, especially if you're hitting some good tanky fortified units and get some stalwart defenders on some frontline stuff. You should be looking pretty nice, but it's not a guarantee.
No. I mean, that's why actually Fafnir Run would have been a good addition, because he would have enforced a different playstyle with them.
Mm-hmm.
Pollux,
mm-hmm.
Dorn, Sigismund, and now I quickly have to look it up.
Diaz?
Diaz, they all have like the same style. They all sit back and reinforce their board. And it's kind of vice versa with Custodes, because you have three warlords that lash out and Shapur sits back. And now with
right.
the fist, you have four warlords that sit back.
Boys, if you want a fight, I'll give you a
fight. What do we got?
Adele, my little dog, 2.5 kilo full of love. You may continue. I am.
That is lovely. It's like my cat somewhere, but you know, he's adorable, but he's a piece of garbage.
This garbage cat.
Listen, I love him. He's a piece of garbage.
How about you, Axel? What are your thoughts on the Fist Warlords?
Yeah, that was one of the reasons why I wanted Ron so much, to build off of what was just said, is he was different. There's too much, and I build my board, and I defend, and I defend. I know that's the Imperial Fist gimmick. I do. But I really just wanted to see someone break the trope. Does that... Yeah, they're really not my style, the Fist Warlords. It's just all a lot of slow board defense, defense, defense. I know I main word bearers, but I let one troop stick to the board and then I win. I don't like building up a slow board, okay?
Well, I think slow is subjective, and I'll defend the Imperial Fist here to that to some degree, just because... you know, I like them, but I think you can win with Pollux before 7 energy. Like it doesn't, it's not every game, but it's very doable. A slow board is the death guard. When I think slow, I think them. I mean, there's probably even a slower faction beyond them, but I mean, the fists, securing a board can happen slower, but winning, depending on what combos you've got built out, or you know, like if you've got 3 or 4 troops and then you throw down an Archimus, great, that's pretty strong. That's one way to go about it. If you've got the fortified outpost, stalwart defenders, and a couple of turrets, you've built something, but you have to sit there for several turns and have those pews happen. And if in ladder, especially where your opponents have more likely to have a dex to answer various scenarios, you're going to encounter more defensive satellites or jams or flanking troops, things to help disrupt that, so it's not as guaranteed, which makes it harder. But I wouldn't say that they've got like a slow win. I mean, definitely I think Dorn is probably the longest game option. Like, I mean, if he's playing, a Dorn can win early, but he's more likely to win late than anything. I think Diaz will probably fall in that gate too. If you win, I think, unfortunately, I agree. I mean, I'd say, unfortunately, I agree with you guys both that I think Rand would have offered something new and different, and it's unfortunate that we didn't get him, or that we're not going to get him. By the time this episode airs, we will not have, we think we'll have like one day left. We'll have a day less,
and unless Pirate can rally the entire game community behind him.
Yeah, it's just, it's unfortunate.
I think that's a major issue with the way the Warlords are chosen too, because you usually went with the new stuff.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, definitely.
If you could choose before you start, okay, I want my points to go to that Warlord or to that card, that's not always a Warlord we choose, then I think that the results would have been different.
Somewhere. Absolutely. Oh, 100%. Yeah.
And that's what everyone wanted too, but you know.
Yeah.
I mean, I start an event, I choose to play a one-time ticket or a 10-time ticket, and then I get asked, do I want this and do I want that? And then I can start choose or craft my deck. I guess that would have been possible or will be possible. Maybe they will change it at some point. But
and it's not like it's impossible to code.
So.
I said it's not like it's impossible to code. There's really no reason for it not to be.
Right. Yeah, it's just it's like one additional selection. Yeah.
Yeah. One more menu you got to click. That's it. I don't even think it would be confusing. Maybe it would confuse players. Maybe that's the reason we don't have it, guys.
Ugh. It's confusing to the new players, guys.
We can't have it because it's confusing new players.
I think 1,000 different cards and like 100 warlords are confusing enough.
No. I think it would confuse too many players, an extra pop-up menu.
And actually, I think the coding, they could do it just with like the drafting. You draft at the first pack, you draft. They didn't even need to do any coding. So I think it's very doable, but maybe they just haven't noticed. So if we say it often enough on the podcast, maybe they do.
Maybe we gotta fly to Spain, all of Team Germany, and us too. We can go send them a strong worded message. And maybe they'll then understand that, hey, maybe people actually want this. Because we've been asking for it in QAs. And they've always hit us the same with, we think events are currently fine. They're not.
Yeah, maybe we can really change it. Hey, there's three German guys standing outside. We better do that now.
Yeah, but I think the QA, my experience from it is at least the answers are always like, everything's good here, no worries.
Everything is fine as everything's on fire.
Yeah, but then, like, yeah, exactly. But then a month later or 2 months later, there might be a change. Like, even with DD, they were very much claiming in the last one that I attended that that's all fine, and then they did change. So, yeah,
right.
Saying it does have a thing, I just don't want to be like right away, like, yeah, okay, you guys are right, we'll do everything what you said.
Yeah.
To give some credit to Everguild, they do answer our questions. It's not the answer we always want, and it's not always useful, but there's actually one guy sitting down for 2 or 3 hours and answer every question. That isn't something that is usual for a company that does such games.
My favorite, though, is when they just hit us with a book quote.
Yeah, it's nice to get the attention or the time from from whoever is sitting to answer the questions. Sometimes it's a little frustrating when the answers are not substantial or there's anything to them. We'll pass it along. Hopefully they are, you know, and at least you get to hear that you get a response. So they heard what was said. And there's only been, in my opinion, a couple Q&As where I literally like felt like nothing was achieved. No information was received. Nothing was gained. It was like, why did they have there? Nothing was announced. Normally, at least with a Q&A, it feels like at least you can get some feedback that, hey, they are seeing the same thing that everybody else is seeing. They see it, and maybe they will work on it at some point, at the very least, or they acknowledge that that is a perception of a part of the community. You know, like, yes, we know that this is a problem, and we will continue to keep an eye on it. Okay, well, sometimes that might be an eye on it for 2 to 3 months. Sometimes it might be a week or two, but at least they're aware of it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I agree. But I think some big issue is that defense could have been addressed. You can read it in the card. Every other card has some cap lock. It's 3 units up to a point value of 4 energy, and Desperate Defense didn't have that. Just had put in 2 cards and they got frontline. And I say, whoa, that's huge. At first, I wasn't sure about the impact that card had, but you could craft decks to drop some 8 or 9 energy cards, two of them.
Mm-hmm.
And actually, some cards could enter the game which never were designed to have the frontline trait, like Coriol Seth or Abominable Intelligence.
Yep.
You get past them. That was a huge effort on your side. And often you could get rid of one of those units, and the other still is on the board. And then your opponent can play that same card again, so you have to face three of them. And with Warlord's Line failed, that could happen so soon. And you could even play two desperate defenses in one turn. And there's no chance that can be fair. I mean, you have to see that if you design a card.
Right. Yeah, and I know, like, they've mentioned before, like, the ramp and style of the energies. They're like, hey, that's our intention. Well, I don't think it was your intention to put one card and allow those decks. And I think, I mean, it's something that they should have caught earlier. It's something that they should have paid attention to earlier. Because, I mean, I remember way back, even before Desperate Defense was a thing, there's always been those meme images, you know, for like Assault Tarvitz that plays Lurnia Hydra with 4 energy or 3 energy or whatever. Like, yeah. Oh, it can be done. And then you literally created a meta where decks were doing that every game. It was like a consistent thing. It was no longer the rare exception. It was like, this is the way the game is shifted now, and people are playing it this way constantly. Like, that's not, I don't think you intended it to happen that way.
I mean, it was with Desperate Defense, there was 1 month especially where it was, you play and you see fail and you know exactly what will happen. It's Asteroid Belt, Desolated Ground, Warp Turkey, Desperate Defense with 7 energy. Yeah, thank you. Thank you for the match.
Yeah.
I've not heard him called Warp Turkey before.
I've heard the Warp Chicken before, but Warp
Turkey?
Yeah,
Chicken. That's new. I love that.
He looks more like a Skeksy to me, you know? From
well,
the Dark
some
Crystal.
Bird, some bird, that's it.
It's a bird. We've all agreed upon that.
That's true. He's avian-like.
Some really annoying bird. But I guess we drift off topic.
We drifted a little off topic. That's okay. It all comes back
topic,
full
though.
Circle. So moving into the bulk of the Imperial Fists, I think they're core feature obviously is Bastion, and I talk about what Bastion is. It's pretty self-explanatory, but it's basically additional health on the defense than anything.
I didn't even say something. I was too busy drinking and listening to you, but it's okay. No one's before midnight.
Midnight.
Ahead. I'm joking.
Are you?
Go ahead.
Don't cry in your gin. It's okay. It's okay.
I'm coming myself. It's okay. I'm aroused by your voice, SkuffD, as always.
We didn't get your take on the Warlords. You go ahead. You go ahead and chime in before we talk about Bastion, then we'll kick off with you.
Do we really
no,
have to
it's
let
fine.
Him
talk?
Yes, we have to suffer the gin.
Is it really suffering though, if that's what we all want?
Okay.
I would like some gin right now.
I think we all would.
I see you. I mean that you're allowed to talk, go on.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
It's a major mistake to allow him to talk, but
I think too, but we have
to. It's only polite.
Shut up! No, it's fine. Well, like, go ahead with the regular themes. I'm playing Juan here. I'm busy anyway. You go ahead. Because Juan is a very good player. He was number one rated by Pirate Lahai in this sheet. From the World Cup, so I have to focus here. And he's showing off his new deck with Branson.
Oh yes, I've seen that deck. Juan's I want to say friend, but then that would admit me being friends with Juan, and I don't want to do that. He's
friends.
Listening to this right now.
So I'm going for a 33% Terran reality here, by the way.
That's
good.
Luck.
Hope it sticks.
Chaos will be on your side.
Wait, I'd make it 50%. Let's do it. Juan will be super mad because I already won the first one. Yeah, I won again. Easy game. Easy game, Juan. Get good or something.
We'll hear his opinion on that shortly.
We will. Yeah, he'll chime in somewhere.
Yeah, I won both RNGs on Terran Reality. He'll be
pissed. He tried to ask me to convince you to let him pop on the podcast. It's like, wait, no, Juan. I can't do this.
That's
sorry,
too
buddy.
Many people. Three's a crowd.
He started speaking German at me and said, can I come on now? And I still had to say no.
No, he can't speak German. I don't believe it. I don't believe that Juan can speak German. He sounds Mexican.
No, he was typing just German.
Pirate tried to speak German once too, and I think he declared war on half Asia.
Ja, ja, der macht hier einen auf Allmann und dabei ist auch eine Pro irgend so ein Kanack. Also kannst du knicken, dass der hier auftauchen kann, Freunde.
See, the only part of that I understood was Kanack.
You got
but
the main
something
part,
different. It means something different.
Listen, it sounds like Canadian, so you know what? I'm happy.
I think I even top decked Diesel here. I think if he watches this, he would be pretty mad. Get wrecked by Adams. Nice deck.
By Edible? That's a different kind of getting wrecked.
Zero RNG here involved. It was pure skill, Juan. Pure skill. Oh, another challenger. Who is it? Chaotic 1999. Ah, that's one from our lodge group, right?
Is that Chaotic from Merciless? Yeah. Oh. So, the Bastion mechanic is it's health, extra health on the defense. And
yeah.
You lose it on the offense.
I got something
what you got?
Here. Yeah, definitely.
Go for it.
When I first saw Bastion, when I first saw Dawn especially, I thought, holy shit, this is crap. Like, I know comparing legions between themselves is not a good idea, but we have six, you know? Vincent Six from the Raven Guard. He gives 2 health for 1 energy. I know it's a rare warlord and he can't do anything besides that, but I took that as a... So to say, I took it as an orientation point. Like this guy gets
Paris,
1 health,
like
2 health for 2 health for 2 energy, for 1 energy, mm-hmm. And Dawn gives 2 Bastion, and Bastion is like worse health. It's only defensive health. So when attacking, you don't lose Bastion. It's like bad health, and he gives 2 Bastion.
I am master of the
so 2 bad health for 2 energy. Was like, holy shit, this is so bad. And then it turned out that they're actually pretty good. So, unfortunately, they nerfed... Well, what? Unfortunately. Not unfortunately, they nerfed the sisters, right?
They got what was coming to them.
Yeah.
They deserved it. I don't think anyone
they was deserved it. And I was playing Dawn, not last season, I didn't play Dawn that much. But start of this season, I played Dawn. I also uploaded the video on him. And he was so good against pro. Like you needed to play like really long games, between like 10 and 15 minutes usually. But if you played like smart and you just played cool, you just cleared your board, kept your stuff. Crow had such a trouble dealing with that shit, and I really liked it, you know. And I thought, well, fuck. Now they nerfed Crow, and now I don't have any reason to play Dawn anymore. Because Dawn, you saw him, he had like 48% win rate, I think. 45 was current.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and I was really disappointed with that, to be honest.
Yeah,
I was surprised on the meta report, his usage rate was pretty high,
yeah,
but his win rate was very low.
Cool. It's fun to build that board, it's like Iron Hands playstyle, but good. Iron Hands are good again. If you saw my stream from last time, Santa is rocking. I don't know how Ferris and so on are doing, but Santa is rocking. So anyway, good thing about Dawn was he was really good against fucking Crow. He really countered her pretty nicely. I had really a lot of convenient games against her as Dawn. But right now the meta is like Solar Auxilia. And knights and solar auxilia knights, so the combination of the two most busted things right now in the game.
Heard about those, I haven't seen any yet.
You haven't seen any yet
because you're probably two in the 2.5k practice, bruh. So, anyway,
no, I play low Terra ranked, I just don't peek too high because I don't try to.
Oh, fuck, I completely forgot about Terra side. Fuck my life.
Well, the OTK Cypher thing is still going on.
Yeah,
so.
Fuck OTK Cypher. Like, you know, if you are active on Discord, you probably heard my fucking rant about Abrasax. If you know this guy. Abrasax, right? Last season I went for a top 10 like the first time. Usually I don't give a shit about that and it's stressful and so on. And I said, well, fuck it. I kind of played Nessa at the start of the season and I kind of catapulted me into the high ranks almost instantly. So I thought, yeah, why not? I'm gonna try it, and I did it. And the guys in the top 10, they all played like meta stuff, or they were like pretty good, like one of those, or combination of both. And I was super pissed at fucking Abrasex because he's so fucking dense. Like, no offense, but Abrasex won't watch this anyway. He's probably not active on social media. This guy was dense as fuck. He played badly, but he still somehow managed to stay in like top 20. And on the last day, on the last fucking day, when I was at work, I was half asleep and all that shit. And I, it was like 5 or 6 a.m. I was fighting for my top 10 spot, and there's this guy playing his fucking corn cipher. And it pissed me off because it's such a cheese. It's like playing solitaire, you know? It pissed me off that he did that. And I don't know. Fortunately, he lost because of his own stupidness. There was Balgard also pushing for top 10. And Chaotic, that was stupid as fuck, by the way. Why your board was better than mine? Why would you do that? Anyway, so... and he was pushing for top 10 along with Balgard. And I give it to Balgard. Balgard is a good player. If he gets for top 10, sure, go ahead. It's fine. Balgard deserves it. And this guy, in the last 5 minutes of the season, he played another game, so he had a safe spot in the top 10. He had a safe spot. And he played that last game and lost. And that's why he went to rank 11. If you look at the leaderboards from last season in the game, you will see him in at the 11th spot. And that's why he was nervous or something. He played a game in the last 11 seconds or something like that. I fucking lost my shit. That was so fucking stupid. I'm GG Chaotic, by the way. And yeah, I hated Cypher, and I don't remember what the original topic here was about, actually.
The Bastion? Yeah, that's a good transition. You started with Dorne and Sisters of Silence, and then somehow gradually, shifted over.
I warned you, don't let him speak.
Don't let me speak, dude. I'm like completely, I have ADHS or something. So... Bastion, yes, I thought it was originally Bad Health, like I explained earlier with Six. And yeah, in the end it turned out, if you have Stalwart up, and if you manage to establish a ward, because there's no way you get past Stalwart and like, I don't know, these 3-5 guys, 3-3 guys with Bastion 2 and a couple of turrets. So I discovered, I don't know, my favorite Imperial Fist Wallet is actually Prolix. The guy I deemed really bad, he doesn't play that much with Bastion, but he has so cool combos with fucking Stone Gauntlet, Gunfried, and Grohagen Squad. It works all so fucking well. I really enjoy him. Like, he's low initiative, 30 HP, think about it. It's like bad. But, fuck, I really liked it. Let's play Prolix against, I'm pessimistic.
Well, Prolix is a fun game. With the low initiative too, he gets that counterattack most of the time.
Yes, and if he was a high initiative, it's bunkers or medium initiative.
Yeah.
Because if you go first with Pollux, it's insane because you can't simply deal with the shit he spawns with his ability. It's not like the turrets from Cambitias. It's not like It's not like let me think. Are broken. What else spawns that's something tricky. Between
like the closest people. Thing would be the Astartes that Vulcan creates. Like that's the closest thing you can compare it to.
Yeah, they're also annoying, but whatever, I think, right?
But you can only have one. So yeah, I think if he could just spawn
but
the board
Pollux,
full of
this,
them,
this
that would also
to
be
ramp, great. Ramp damage on the board, it is stronger than I thought. His problem is still that he has low HP, but I think it's still justified because the combos you can pull off of him are just ridiculous.
And he's got a lot of frontline factions.
You actually want to have that counterattack card.
Yes.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, Pollux. Pollux putting out, Pollux, I said, like Stone Gauntlet with him at board. Like even if you're just firing off 4 or 5 twos, that sometimes is enough to do what you need to do, whether it's to finish it or if you've got just Dissy from a supply lines, there you go. That's even better because now you're getting 4 threes. But the 30 health is the thing. If you can't stick up a front line to protect him late game, or you don't manage to get Bastion on him, that's the one thing that he, you know, obviously Stalwart Defenders doesn't do for the Warlord is put Bastion on the Warlord. Like, he could still be vulnerable to a direct damage or an unstoppable, you know, a Warlord that's got juiced up attack or something like that, whether it's Sanguinius or Korax, who could finish off with like a sentenced combo, something from there. But
yeah, I guess someone like Horus with a lot of tactics also will have little problem with him.
Right. Yep, exactly. Because he can take the twos from your guys, all right? At that point, it really is a race, like, how much damage is he going to hit on your Warlord before you can have some bodies down to combo, whether it's comboing them with the Archimus to increase their stats, comboing them from a Stone Gauntlet or a Justice, with the frontline to protect your Warlord. Yeah. Sorry. Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Well, also, I think when if you're talking about Bastion with like the meta out now that you can have like any card on any, at least any tactic, any deck in a way. Mm-hmm. If you get them from Kaizo Lane, some factions just go completely out of control.
Yeah.
Like, anything, yeah. Not anything troop based, but things that have like medium health troops, they just, and there's nothing you can do.
Yeah. And well, the thing I liked about Bastion that, you know, is kind of the underscored point is defensive health, but really what it allows you to do for the Fist faction is play your troops differently. Like, you can hold them off on the defense. Like, it's you know, like, obviously if they take too much lethal when they're attacking, you'll lose them. But if they've got Bastion 6, you can have them sit there for 3 or 4 turns ready to go to when you want to throw out that attack. And in the meantime, they still can soak up 6 damage. And if you've got that on a frontline troop or frontline that stuns somebody who attacks it, or, you know, Stalwart Defenders constantly adding to that. I don't know. Like, it's on the surface when they first talked about it, it's like, okay, it's kind of, how does this work? But in practice, after playing it and using it, I really like it. I like it a lot. I would have liked it if we had a Warlord who could... I know we've got, like, Archimus in the event right now, which can give, you know, Bash into his whole board, which includes himself. But I would have liked it if we had a Warlord that did a little bit more with Bastion on themselves, so you could work with cards like Shield Charge, you know, for that kind of, like, little bump and charge. I know that's a random target, but it would still be interesting. I think there's ways to do Sigismund that way. I think you could have probably done a decent Ron deck that way. Hmm. We just Ron, won't see those.
Ron, I think,
yeah.
I gotta agree with some of those people saying he will add a different playstyle to it, because he won't really. Yaki will still play the same shit with a little, I don't know how to say, with a little, how to say it? Just let me think real quick. I have a little handicap, so you don't have the protective abilities of Dawn, or you can't spawn shit like Pollux. But what he adds to the Imperial Fist is reach. Yeah, that's what Imperial Fists really lack. And I think it would have been pretty funny, actually. I don't know. It's like... wait, I have 9 energy. What do I play? So, anyway. I know that... Cambadias, I'm excited for him, to be honest, because he will, I think, enable the structure game plan. I tried structure Dorn and it really didn't work at all. Like, the Dorn I uploaded on my channel in the end worked really well. Structure-wise, I don't know. I really wanted to play it like Mount Ferris and the Fortified Outpost combo and all that shit. I thought it would be pretty funny. And I don't know, I think he will enable it, but Ran? Like, I think the goal with him would be to not use his ability at all until you can finish off your opponent. So you kind of add some draw to your deck, maybe, I don't know. Wait, let me check if I have lethal. Oh yeah, I do. So I just think that you will add some draw into your deck, like the piece of others or something, a lot of cycle. I just play the usual Imperial Fist stuff. So like the value troops of the Imperial Fist. And what he will just add, that you play on a little handicap, that you can protect your troops or spawn more stuff, but that adds up that you will simply have, if you have like, I don't know, a hand of 7 or 8 cards in, I don't know, on turn whatever, and your opponent was busy like clearing your troops with his face, that you simply can finish him off with a 16 or 17 or 18 damage swing. That's like the idea. So you dump your whole hand and you suddenly your warlord has 16 attack. Like that's insane. So he adds insane reach to the Imperial Fist, and they don't have that. The only good reach card they have right now is the Gunfried dude. But Gunfried needs support to be really good. So I think Ran would actually be an interesting addition. I also thought that he's kind of shit. He has no synergy with the cards. What the fuck is this? But it does have been interesting to see him, you know?
Considering orders from Terra, that reach could be a lot higher.
It could be, or you've got Felnix, which lets you draw 4 cards and gives you more energy to combo more stuff if you've got drill sites. Yeah, he could go crazy.
Yeah. I mean, we'll just never see it. You can drop 6 cards, so you're at 14 attack. And then you can order from Terra. I mean, 14 attack times 2, 28. At that point, you will have your opponent down to that amount of health.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, at that point, I also gotta say, I'm lit as fuck. I didn't eat almost anything, and I made a really strong gin tonic, like 10 CL. And, ooh.
It's catching up with them. We have to catch it up before midnight fades.
How are my boys doing? How are my boys doing?
To be fair, I don't see any difference between the drunk midnight and the midnight I usually encounter.
I'm more incoherent. I tend to jump.
Maybe longer sentences.
Much?
Usually we can not interrupt you.
I'm a bit
nicer. Now we can interrupt you.
And I speak longer. Anyway, where were we?
Bastion.
Bastion.
But I think we said a lot of things about Bastion, right?
I think we've talked about Bastion as far as it goes. Like, overall, how would you guys rank it in terms of, like,
as a trait?
Yeah.
That's hard. It's good. It's good. It's good. Because it synergizes well with the Legion. Because they are super defensive, but I don't know. If it was, I don't know, on any other faction would be shit. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I think that's fair.
The faction's really built towards
it works with the faction, but as a like vanilla keyword, I think it's shit.
I agree, but I think you still think Stalwart is a really, really strong card. Even because it just gives the whole board. Even if it's like some fake HP. It's like for the whole board. I mean, you can imagine. I mean, we have the thing Marcus now, where it gives the whole board of solar things survivor, and that's completely OP. And so this is not, I mean, that's obviously a bit stronger, but you can remove it. But the Stalwart Defender, you can't remove, and it just does something quite similar. I think that's strong, but in general, not. Like plus 2, it's like, yeah, okay, whatever.
Especially with a faction that can drop multiple units in a turn. Like, that's a big thing that they've got for them. Like, you're not just giving, Bastion 1 to a 7-drop troop. You can give it to 3 or 4 troops the next turn.
Yeah, that's true.
Alright.
But I think the whole faction is designed around Stalwart Defenders. If you don't have it, the turrets die like flies. That one extra HP, especially in a mirror matchup, that makes a big difference. It's like with the Reckon Claw and Night Lords. The Legion is kind of designed around that.
Yes.
So with Night Lords, it's like everything might have flank, so they have to be a bit weaker. And it's the same thing with Imperial Fist. They all might have Bastion 1 from turn 4 going on, so they have to have a little less health than the usual 3 or 4 energy draw has. So if you're really unlucky and you don't get Stalwart Defenders, you can deal with Imperial Fists very easily. So
I think if they were to change Stalwart, and not that I'm advocating for it, because I think it's a fine card. It does nothing for the Warlord. That's for me, that's the reason why it does everything else it does. But if they were to change it to be less impactful and just give Bastion to, like, adjacent troops, or give it, relentless instead of resolution, you would have to adjust other cards in the faction to counter that. Because like you said, like it's whether that's an intentional design or not, they have only been successful because of Stalwart being there for them to help them. I mean, you can play Fists without Stalwart, but once you have a single Stalwart in your play, like, you can see the obvious impact. Like, it's a huge difference. It's like that one card that really holds, you know, pushes the faction to the next level of play, basically.
Yeah. Just because you can doesn't mean you should.
Like, right. I'm not advocating for that. I think that, if anything, I would advocate for about four or five other cards to be changed to be improved, but that's just me.
Yeah.
All right. Well, we're getting into, I guess, I don't know if we got much more topic to talk about the card size. I mean, I guess if we had to pick top three Imperial Fist cards, I'll just go down the row. You're going to go Stalwart. I will not disagree on that. What are your other two picks?
Yeah, we agree all three on that.
Yeah.
So number one is
all Stalwart. All five of them.
Yep. All five. Okay. That... I would say number two is Gunfleet.
Yeah.
For me, number two would be the 3/3 legendary.
Oh, Ahmed.
Ahmed, yeah.
I go with B-side here. It's an early card, even if you have to counter attack card, it has Bastion 4.
Yeah.
That's really good.
Ahmed is number 3 for me. So Stalwart, Gunfleet, Ahmed, that's my ranking.
Yeah, I mean, Gunfleet is for me third.
Stonefist? Stonefist.
Oh.
The 4 energy. Okay, so. 4 energy common.
Stone Gauntlet, okay.
Stone Gauntlet?
I don't think. Alright.
First bot. I'm not sure. I'm kind of undecided between Fortified Outpost and Kestros. Because depending on the warlord you play or the board you already have, Kestros either gives you some initiative or Fortified Outpost just can ramp up your damage. So, one of those. I can't decide.
Yeah, it's kind of true. Like, obviously, the event play is very, very different from ladder because you can have things five times. But if you have five Kestrels in your deck, then you're usually going on a 12x run or 12-win run.
Yeah. Event's fun in that regard.
Event is a little wonky, that's for sure. I'm gonna have to go with. I feel like Midnight's choice. I'm gonna back that up too. I think Justice is my second, and Ahmed is my third. That's a tough call between both of them because they both serve a very good purpose. I don't think there's a wrong way either way. I think it's that close. Stalwart definitely is the number one, but I think they both, like, one helps lock a board early. And the other one helps, like, drive the hammer home late. Like, the better hammer, not the recently buffed hammer.
Which didn't need a buff, in my opinion.
No. they gave it to shut up one guy on Discord.
Listen, Mort is happy, and then the devs will gain more money, and it's a win-win all around.
Let's be real. Mort is not happy. Mort will never be happy.
But we can lie and say that he might be happy, okay?
He was happy for a minute. In that one moment, he saw joy, and his heart swelled two sizes that day.
And then he complained about something else.
Yes, exactly.
Yep. I'm pretty sure he did, actually, too.
So if I complain long enough about the Custodes, maybe I get my buff, too. But I think I have to give Evergill some money.
That's the way to go.
You need to ping Evergills, like, once a day. You need to ping them, man. Like, Hell of Service Legions, like what he did is baiting, like, money. He always said, I will give you money. And that's how he won.
They did, and I bet you he gave money.
How much did he give him, you think? Yeah, that's a question for the Q&A. How much did Mort pay you?
How much did the IF buffs, or IH buffs cost, and how many do we have to pay for Custodes?
Yeah, there you go.
That's the question.
So 1 hour of a developer can be, like, a decent amount, so maybe you paid for around 1 hour.
Yeah, you pay. I'll pay an hour of your time to code it for me. Come on, let's go.
Maybe you need outside developers.
A lot of money, but you know what?
Already cast with a
So toxic.
If someone already provides the code and just sends them like the code, this just put this in your code. Maybe then they're like, that could be.
And now we got to find out how much to pay to get Ron added right now. We can still change it, boys.
Get him on the back door. Maybe he'll be in this campaign thing. You never know.
I don't know.
No, this campaign takes place on fall.
Well, they said there will be a 54, and there. I guess that will be Ron.
Yeah.
I hope it's not, and they add another one, just to spite Pirate.
Yeah, the Archimus. It's already there.
Yeah.
Like, just with a different picture?
Well, I think Justicia is also going to be an event warlord from what I read. And there was also, in the story, the Battle of Fall, there was a Terminator first captain, I forget his name, and he was on the boarding party that boarded Perturabo's flagship to try to take him down. I imagine he would be included in that. I forget his name, and it's unfortunate because he got captured and, like, totally fucked up by Fabius Bile, so...
You know, as what happens when you get captured by Chaos.
That's true. If you get captured by Fabius Bile, you're not going to have a good time. It's
if you
not
get captured by
well
Chaos, bad times are coming. You may as well die at that point. You may as well die.
We're getting into the toe end of things. We're kind of talking about, we did player introductions, but when you guys are not playing Legions, what do you do? What other things do you do? Games, occupations, hobbies? Midnight, we'll start with you.
Currently I'm playing Warhammer Chaos Bane. Just a bit.
Ooh, I heard that's fun.
Yeah, it's an action RPG, but...
Death is coming.
It's okay.
Death to the false emperor.
It's not the best I've ever played, but it's fun. And then besides that, well... I think I'm pretty occupied with my job, woman and dogs, to be honest, so... all
good thing to be occupied by.
The only thing I'm kind of have time for then is from time to time run around the park a bit to counteract my pizza and alcohol consumption.
That's what you do.
Fair enough.
Hey, how about you, B-side?
What do I do? I don't actually play that many other games these days.
What do I do?
I'm just too old for it, and job takes too much time. And yeah, but apart from that, I don't have a dog, but it sounds like... I spent a lot of time similar to Midnight job. And everything around the normal private life. Yeah. Not too crazy, but yeah, it's also alright. I really like my job, so it's fine.
Don't lie. You have no life.
What do you do for a living, if you don't mind us asking?
I'm a researcher. I'm like, I do like microbiome research. Like, what bacteria?
He's responsible for the COVID pandemic.
Oh, he's the one who made it? Alright.
Yeah, he is the one.
I only do bacteria, no viruses.
We don't know. You might still be in charge of that. You don't have to tell us the truth right now.
I wish I was. That would be really cool. That would be pretty epic.
To claim, like, it was me! It was me all along!
Yeah, I think it on the 15 minutes of fame are 15 minutes because someone would kill you right after, but it would be pretty impressive.
I like your odds. They're not good odds, but I like them.
Yeah,
how about you, Valdor?
One in a million is...
Hey, one in a million is still bad.
I'm sorry. Actually,
what do you... Oh, no, it's... I was just adding on to something B-side said. Go ahead.
Oh, okay. I'm a chemistry and biology teacher, and when I don't play Legions, I actually like to play volleyball. I hit the gym a lot when my job and girl allows me to do so. But aside from that, I... really buy basically anything when you stamp a Warhammer logo on it. I really like that stuff, especially the books lately. I've read all of the Horus Heresy Legions books, Horus Heresy books for the book series, and also some of the tabletop. I would like to play it a bit more, but time unfortunately is limited. So I mainly collect the boxes and they collect dust on my shelf. But
have you seen the new Kill Team content?
Yeah, I've seen it, but aside from reading, I haven't got very much out of it. I started at one or two boxes of Adeptus Titanicus because I wanted to have at least one of the smaller Titans. But it's a lot of time painting them, building them, and so on.
Yeah,
and as for legions, yeah, it's just one an hour or two or half an hour you can put in between. You have a small break. You can play one or two games, and that fits the schedule a bit more.
Yeah, I mean the box games and the hobby, the painting and modeling is. Looking back on it, it's like that's super time consuming, and I don't even have the workspace to facilitate it anymore. Like whereas the game, you could pull out the phone, sit on the couch or crash before bedtime, and you know just like play a couple games or sit at the computer. Like it doesn't take near as much effort or time, which is very nice.
Yeah, definitely. Not better than.
I admire the guys that put pictures online of some models they made and painted, and they look gorgeous. And when you hear about that or you listen to them, I made this that way, I made it that way, and it doesn't sound that difficult. And if you try it for yourself, it's like, oh my god, that's like a god level experience and craftsmanship. You need to do that. And your figures always look like shit compared to that, and that's really disappointing.
Yeah, it can be frustrating. Like it's not just a matter like I just put on these mix these two colors. Like, well, that in itself is a skill. Sometimes learning how to mix or how to layer, you know, highlight. At this point, I wouldn't have to relearn how to paint, but I'm not as confident in my painting skills as I was when I was actively painting. I did pretty good. I enjoyed my stuff. Nowhere near on the level of, you know, Golden Demon or, you know, first place competition stuff. But it looked better than just like, you know, one thick coat or three colors on the model enough to be tabletop. Like I enjoyed taking the time to do it. I just don't have the time in my life to sit down and do that anymore.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I always think, I look at a box, it's like, man, yeah, I'd like to have an army, but I'll pass.
Yeah. Or go forward right
I
now.
I mean, your focus shifts, and that's fine. I mean, you gotta do something else, and you still can do part of the hobby, and, like, paint one or two figures, which look really nice, but it's not enough to make a whole army that looks very impressive on a big board. That's just not the time you have.
Yeah.
That's why a lot of people are moving to digital to play the board game now. Or like the tabletop, I guess would be the proper way to say it. Like, I do tabletop sim, I do 30k. 30k normally will bankrupt you if you try to build an army, I swear.
Yeah, all the Forge World stuff is really expensive.
Yeah, Forge World will rob you in an alley while you build your army. That's just how it works.
And you'll just accept it. You don't have. That's just the way they are, man. There's just nothing you can do about it.
And the problem is that the models look so good, so it almost feels justified.
Yeah.
Like, oh man, I love the look of Argyll Tall. His new model is going to be so good. Do I want to get shanked in an alleyway to get him? I don't know.
Probably yes at the end of the day.
Yeah, definitely yes, but I can lie to myself and say maybe I'll say no. So good. I don't know if you've seen Argyll Tall's new model, anyone here, but it is very good.
Yeah.
He's holding up half of an Ultramarine in his hand, which already sells it to me, because he's in ROM
mode. I just wanted to say that with half an Ultramarine at his feet.
Oh yeah, half in his hand, half in his feet, and he's in ROM mode, which is always good looking. Mm-hmm.
Do you have to pay extra for the... because it's like another model in it?
No, but because of its how fancy it is one of the more expensive models, which hurts. Or will be, at least.
Actually, the Forge World pricing, I don't understand. I think when you look at the homepage, some of the Primarchs shift in their pricing.
Oh yeah, none of them are the same.
Sometimes they're more expensive, sometimes they're cheaper, but there seems to be no system behind that. At least none I have ever encountered.
The closest I've been able to figure out is the base. Like, if the base is much more involved or is a bigger set piece, that's the only thing I can take of. Like, that's all the only thing I've been able to come up with.
That might be the main reason behind it, but a lot of them just look random. Like, why is this one an extra $60 over this one when they're the same size?
If Jagatai Khan is on a jet bike, I think that would justify him being more costly. No, or Sanguinius with his wings.
I want him riding a Land Raider with his sword out. Like that one little bit of lore no one really talks about, him riding a Land Raider in the battle on top. So dumb. I love that.
I'm also okay if he's on foot. I mean, there's nothing wrong with him being on foot with the Dao, but I feel like if you don't have him on the jet bike, you're doing him a disservice.
Wasn't there a piece of lore where Angron actually rode atop of the Cockburrow when they were facing the Ultramarines?
I wouldn't be surprised, but I don't remember that.
I think that was what's the one book where Horus tries to assemble all of the traitor Primarchs? And it's shortly before the Siege of Terra starts, where they meet at I forgot the name.
I know what you're talking about, but I can't remember the title of that one.
So, I don't remember if he was on the call.
I think I'd remember.
Yeah,
that.
He was. Perturabo had to get him.
I'm not doubting you. It's just I don't remember that line. That line is amazing.
It's Slaves to Darkness.
All right.
And I think Perturabo beat the shit out of him, and then he joins the corps again, and they were attacking some Ultramarines who were heading their direction, and Angron faces them, and he's literally riding Conqueror.
I need to find this exact quote.
It's Slaves to Darkness.
But he's in Demon Prince mode at that point,
yep.
Right?
Yeah.
Okay. I mean that's kind of I could see it. I could see that. I mean, it's a giant capital starship, but he's in Demon Prince form. He's out in the void. He's just eager. He's so eager to kill Skulls that he can't even be contained within the hull of the ship. I could see that.
Yeah, but even that scene, even for Warhammer standard, is like turned on 11.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. He's flapping his wings in space. Fly me closer.
My sword.
Yes.
I love that so much.
Well, does anybody have anything to plug? Midnight.
Plug?
You got anything to plug? What plugs. Yeah, you talk about your YouTube channel. Are you drifting off?
He's losing consciousness, boys.
Yeah, I think we're catching right at the verge before he kind of slumps in his chair.
Yeah, he's German and Russian. He can take a lot of alcohol.
Yeah. Oh, that's a killer combo.
Yeah. I don't know what to say there. I don't know.
A Russian? Was that right? I don't know.
Yes, I'm Russian living in Germany.
Yeah, then I was right. He can take a lot of alcohol.
I can.
His blood is made of it at this point.
It still doesn't change the fact that I didn't eat anything. But I don't know.
You said you had a banana, right?
That's good enough.
Who's the monkey now?
Axel.
I'm monkey? Thought I was grabbed.
You're still a fucking monkey. You're a fucking ape. Go wow. Face. Face is the place. Me never trade.
I don't even play aggro. I just want to play Ron because he's different than the normal Imperial.
You want to play aggro. You want to go face and never trade.
I play only word bearers, okay?
Yes, you play only word bearers.
Well, I mean, yeah, I built my entire career over only playing word bearers. I play Logar and Zardu.
What career?
Yes, my career being known as a word bearer player.
I know you as a word bearer player.
That's fine. You don't need to know me as a word bearer player, but a lot of people do, and that's what matters to me.
But do word bearers have like, don't they have like a cool name as well, like the Iron Father that Mortem can put in front of his name? So maybe you get really.
I could probably put something chaplain or like apostle, but I don't want to.
Core in front of your name, Core Axel.
I don't want to be Core Axel. I'm happy we got Zardu. For those who wanted Core Pharaon, I understand, but I like Zardu. I like Zardu a lot.
Then there would be one in the game.
No, I still don't know how we got Zardu before Core Pharaon. That didn't make sense to me.
This event where we get Cambodia's over Fafnir.
It wasn't as one-sided, though. It was pretty tight. This one is, like, one-sided to the extreme. Like, I don't even know what the percentage is at this point for victory for Diaz.
I mean, Diaz was decided to be the one for the loyalist legions, and everyone wanted to play him, so...
Yeah. Character-wise, he's a very cool character, but like you said, like, he's... Ran is still alive. Yeah. Beside, you got anything to plug?
No, I don't really have, like, I like all the content creators, so I'll just plug Midnight's YouTube channel, and he always does cool stuff, but there's a few others as well, and then it's cool. And there's also nice stuff about the World Cup in all of those. Not all of those, but some content creators have nice World Cup stuff, so you can see a lot of our games as well.
Educational stuff, funny stuff, World Cup. Event. If you want to get good, watch Midnight.
If you want to get, like, pretty good, like, pretty good. If you want to get, like, to the top, don't. But if you want to get pretty good, that's the place.
Fuck you.
How about you, Valdor? Anything to plug?
Yeah, I have to plug Midnight's channel here as well, because I forgot it the last time I was on the internet. But still, he makes solid videos. The decks list he makes, he explains it. He ramps up a little bit, but that's okay. And I want to mention Physics Teacher's channel. He's made this huge library about the decks, which every new player should take a look at. So as for the others, I mean, there are lots of content creators who make some amazing stuff, but I fear I wouldn't do them justice and I'm surely would forget one, so I stick with those two.
Fair enough.
Also, I'm afraid of Midnight.
Ah, okay.
Afraid?
Afraid.
Yeah. We all,
your ramps, you can get pretty loud.
And also, we're afraid you'll be in front of our door soon.
I have the dedication, I have the funds, I have the mental capabilities. Fuck with me. Boy's gonna be there.
I'm not sure. Right. That was a fearful environment we had to live through during the World Cup.
Well, it's not over yet. We can still win the whole thing.
And endure the fearful environment some weeks more.
Yeah.
All right. Well, I want to thank you guys for, you know, making it on and joining us. I know it's a little different time today, but appreciate Team Germany for taking the time out of their day to be part of the cup. Introduce yourselves and have the chat. Have a drink in a chat.
Thanks for having us, Guff.
All right.
Yes, that was fun.
Lovely to talk.
Yeah.
I was a bit stressed.
Yeah, thanks a lot.
Multitasking, you know, playing games, watching the chat and talking to you. It's, it's hard.
Yeah. All right. Well, I will talk to you guys later. Thank you again. Bye.
Bye. Yes, peace out. Bye. Thank you. Have a good one.
Okay. I just got some stuff. I got some news on text I got to answer, so I'm going to be out. Probably not going to make it to the cup, to the Barnett Legions either, but thanks, guys, for doing the chatting.
Yeah, no,
it was a good thing.
Good conversations. Yeah,
thanks. I hope I didn't have too much background noise. I always saw my thing flaring up, and there's like some.
There's a little, but it'll be fine. It can be cleaned up.
Yeah, not a problem.
Cool.
Yeah, it was nothing where you've ruined. Yeah, like, you're good, man. It's all good.
Yeah, that's good. I wanted to thank you for doing those podcasts. I think that really helps to promote the game. Even if we have a little player base, I think that stuff is important to see that some people are really involved.
Oh, yeah. I like to see the player base for this game grow.
I like to, yeah, exactly. I like just different ways to get out there and advert the game.
I think it does grow. I'm not sure about that. I mean, since Imperial Fists came into the game, lots of players were added, because Imperial Fists are very famous and very beloved.
Oh, yeah. They're cool. They're a cool faction.
Yeah. And I'm curious about the player base. I may ask Evergill that the next time when they make a Q&A.
How many players
is it declining? Is it growing? Are we talking about 1,000 people? Are we talking 100,000 people? I have no idea.
Mm-hmm. We know next to nothing. And I like, though, that Evergild is starting to talk to the players more. Not necessarily us, but at least the mod team. The last couple updates, they've been giving the mods a heads up saying, "This is, we are making an update here shortly, just so you're aware, if it will ruin any tournament or anything."
I think, but that is just my opinion. I have no data to verify that. I think the way the game went, it grew out of their hand. I don't think it was intended to go on for 3 years.
Probably not, to be honest.
Yeah, I think, and still, they were looking at that, and after that expansion, oh, there's still lots of players playing that, and then some came again, and others were added, and after the next expansion, even more players added to it. And I don't think they were planning on that. Mm-hmm. I mean, they said it at some point too. Orphans of War were never planned to enter the game, or I think Custodes were never planned to enter the game. That just happened, and it's still happening. I mean, with the fifth Warlock coming in, I guess the game will go on for a while.
Yeah,
but I could be wrong. So. Yeah, me too.
And I wouldn't complain either. I enjoy this game. I want to see it live a bit longer before it just abruptly dies.
But I think that is up to us if it properly dies or not.
Yeah.
Eventually some people or lots of people will lose interest in it. But the fact that it already goes on for 3 years, it's kind of reassuring.
Yeah, it's impressive too. I honestly expected it to fall down by now. I know some users expect, like, I know a certain Quebecois man has given this game another, like, 3 months of life unless they do something major.
Meaning pirate.
Well, what other Quebecois man do we know?
I said I heard that some time ago, but I heard that before, so I don't think that will happen.
No, I think the game still has plenty of time left in it. Maybe not a full year of staying power with no updates, but I still think the game has some time.
Yeah, the point is, if they keep the updates coming in, if they keep featuring it, then the game will go on. Maybe the player base will shrink a bit, but it will go on. You can make another World Cup, you can make another Lord's War without it ending abruptly and saying, okay, that's it. That will only happen if the devs say, okay, that's it, we can't do anything anymore. Have fun with it, but we won't change anything.
Yeah, and to be honest, I don't know how they'll do it.
I don't know, I'm looking forward to next week, but at the same time, I don't know what to expect.
I mean, I guess that will be the update where we can spend our gems.
The trick here is not to expect too much.
If you can
get slow. Otherwise.
Yeah, that's always better. Guys, I really gotta tap out now.
All good.
Yeah, same here. Yeah. I appreciate it, guys.
Yeah. All right, man. But yeah, thanks a lot, Scuff, for doing the podcast in general and putting it out. And
yeah.
And I'm the only one who got drunk, but...
Hau rein nächste Woche! Wir brauchen noch Punkte!
Ja, Junge.
I don't speak.
Ja, ich mach das schon.
Du weißt schon, du stehst sonst hier, sonst schlafe deine Tür, du Affe. Die Tür. Lege B-Side. Ja, das lief wohl nicht so gut, kommt dann wahrscheinlich. Naja.
Oh, if that happens, please tell me. I'm gonna watch that with a bag of popcorn.
That being said, have a good one.
Alright.
Yeah, alright.
Yep.
I'm gonna respond to all the German. Y'all have a lovely one.
Alright, guys. Bye.
See ya. I'm going up now, too.
Yep.
Oh, all right, boys, we had a little 2-hour almost podcast. No clue how SkuffD is going to upload that, but not my problem. I missed half of that because I was zoned out with player games and reading the chat. But yeah, why the fuck not? Holy crap. Talk with me on podcast next time. I hate Zadu. Is that like the only reason why I should talk with you on the podcast? Because you hate Zadu? I don't even know why. Why would you hate this guy? He's not good. He's not bad. He's like average. You don't see him at all. Out of what? Yeah, you try not eat the whole day and then. Woo! No, by the way, I gotta eat something. Otherwise, I'm gonna get fucked. Let's see what the fridge does. That's looking bad. Oh, nice. It's frozen, though. Well, I'll have to wait then, I guess. He took cause spot, that's why you hate Saru. Yeah, I don't know. If you want to play like cultists, that's what Corphean is for. Just play Rom. It's the same. You have to include Chaos cultists in Rom because he needs 15 Chaos cards. So Corphean had this cultist ability. So just play Rom, man, why? It's just the only thing you're trading is aggro against midrange. That's all. And that's the whole playstyle. I don't know. I don't think it would like be a huge meta change if Core would be in the game right now, because World Bearers don't see that much competitive play right now at all. Demon Host is unreliable, and I don't know. Like, the only guys you see is like Lorga with the Whispers, like Whispers cheese, and from time to time, Raw, and that's all. So, whatever. I somehow need to finish my goddamn challenge. I need to play 20 more troops of 7 or more attack. I hate this fucking challenge, like, seriously. And I don't know what to fucking play. Like, I build that, but fuck my life. Like, it has 3 troops, the idea is to generate more troops, which have 7 or more attack. Oh, this is so annoying, though. That's also the only reason why I played Mortarion. Because, 1, 2, 3, 4. Yep. Knights punish that, and, by the way, we're free to listen to music again.
Welcome to this distant setting.
Just let me know how the volume is. It's too loud or not. So, what are we doing now? Either I finish the challenge, or I feel like playing better, to be honest. Well, we do some more video games. Like all of you that aren't. What's wrong with you boys? Step up again. You need to watch more midnight. Watch more midnight. Get good.
You can laugh cause I prefer to live a life of my own. It's an omen, it's that feeling when you're out of your zone.
Text back on that one, right?
And it's piling up and piling up and on and on. I could stop at any moment, I'll be stopping that arm. There's no point of living if I can't.
Find
I'll be more alive than ever when I'm breaking their bones.
I can't pop pills, no, I can't pop nada. I'm so anxious, pass me my inhaler. I can't stop, wonder will the pain stop? Brain scared, sick, it caught up, plan, I'll pull the trigger. I've been waiting for something to happen, I'm running around with the rubber on my neck. I'm on my way to be something.
Now wait, I still have, I made the guys louder earlier. That's why my desktop sound is so high. It should be better now. Like right now. Okay, anyway. Yo, teacher, what's up? Yeah, I in OBS I set the desktop audio a bit higher because no one heard the other guys except of me. Like, I'm a bit too drunk to for ladder. Like, I'll be honest, if I play ladder now, I'm gonna get fucked. Or will I? I don't give a shit, actually. I don't know if I'm aiming for top 10 anyway. It was such a stress last time. I'm gonna play some Curse. 45% Warlord, you know? But I think this one's working. I still have a solid rate with him. And to back it up, let's lose one. Curses. Top 50 is easy in my opinion. You just have to not be a Muppet. 10 is stressful, yes. And I never tried War Master and I'm never going to try because fuck that. Yeah. Is it patient or vengeful? Probably vengeful. Your War Master takes a lot of time and well, some cheats. I got Rule of Fear, but I'm gonna keep Rule of Fear when he plays Primordial Defenses or something, so I'm just gonna play that. Yeah, that's all pretty useless. I'm gonna go with Spectre, I guess. I'm hitting face because of Vengeful. Yeah, that's a good time for Rule of Fear. I wanted to keep it for Primordial Defenses, but I can't deal with that right now unless I top deck like... yeah, I don't top deck at all. Let's see what this guy brings. Tithe. And Bombs. I think Tithe is the most safer choice. Bombs can work, but... I don't know which scenario, so let's get Tithe. Yep, here's the Stalwart on Curve. Classic. Night Scythe's doing work. What the fuck is this? When an enemy attacking Warlord takes yours instead. Mental is shit. Fuck, I think I'm gonna take the Gamma Order here. Damn it. That's Italian crap. Okay. That's a bad tempo swing in my opinion. But he's building up a board, right? Let's just develop the scythes. They are scary and shit. Yeah, what do I want to Thirst? I barely play any troops, man. Like, Thirst doesn't do much, really. That's a bit premature, in my opinion. If I play that, I'm at 1, 2, 4. Yeah, I have too many cards in hand to play that. And now... I'm gonna be at 9, that's fine. One Chubik proc, boys. I still didn't draw my Mercy and Forgiveness, and I only have one Willoughby in my hand. Don't. No life, dude. Never lucky, rubber ducky. Well, I can transform, that's an easy Melgator in my opinion. Let's also play Chosen. I need to face bash, because of Vengeful. It's like the only way to win this shit. I'm gonna transform now and hope that he plays more stuff that kind of baits Tithe. I'm not torn down. Yeah, very good. I think that's a good point to Tithe. Too bad I can play the Long with Shrek. Yeah, well, the deck on, just play event. I know it sounds cheesy, but event is where you get all the resources from for this game. Oh crap. Where's my Mercy and Forgiveness, man? Top bottom 10 cards. Second stalwart. Alright. There we go. That's super bad. Like, what do I need to draw here? Don't really have anything to deal with the fucking turrets, and this is gonna deal 15 damage to me next turn, even more. Yeah, I'm gonna lose this one, unfortunately. Yeah, here are the orders. But that won't help me at all. I need to mitigate the damage here. I'm just gonna attack with him because he's gonna die next turn anyway. Because of Stone Gauntlet. That's basically it.
Death is nothing compared to vindication.
Well, Ofeta, you get 5 wins per win for the first 10 wins, so 50 gold. And then you get only 1 gold. It's not that much. Like, still, your safest bet is doing event. Let's play Center again, I think. I think he's the most safest pick right now. For me, at least. Yeah, from regular play you get like 150 gold max, so you finish the challenge. If you finish the challenge, it's like from 40 to 60 gold. The daily mission crate doesn't give that much gold, it's usually between 15 and 25 or something. And then the daily wins, so for the first 10 wins you get 5 gold, and then every consecutive win only gives 1 gold. So yeah, still your best bet are events.
Scary.
That's looking fairly good.
Victory lies before us.
Oh boy, the demons are coming. But I got enough AoE to heal with them unless he pops whispers, but I don't really care about his whispers. I don't play many troops. Unfortunately, he got survivor on the Malkiel. Pileblade. Alright. Let's draw first. last rifles. Don't need the belt, not really. That's a cardinal. Oh, I'm fucking stupid. I can't play drunk. Why did I play belt now? Oh fuck my life. I'm not gonna play ladder after that. Like, because of that, I'm missing a shit ton of hammer damage. This is so bad. Oh man. Like, this would have cleared this board, now I take 8 damage from these guys. And... why did I play the belts? I thought I was at 9 energy and I would have drawn a card. More demons. He plays 2 dark channelings. That's so greedy, man. I mean, unless he has birth in me a sword, I'm fine, right? I could also, like, play it safe. So let's last rifle. Mortar. That works too, I guess. Here's the corpus. Astra, I guess. Yeah, too bad. But it's still fine. Try the window. I take 8 from that, whatever, I don't care.
To witness my shame.
Yep. I want to make at least 15 today, to be honest, so I need so I need 21 more points. Like, 400, 250 would be fine today. Let's see if we can do it. Tartrabo. It's a good matchup. Oh, that's a bot. Whatever. What's more like that?
You are not so scary. Take the iron within.
Ah! Yeah, that has to go. The last one of the doors was pretty good in this time. Yeah, I can play belts, I want to kill that. Ah, oh, fuck my life. I'm not gonna attack with that. Or do I? He will probably play his counter attack next turn. I can know the spot. Yeah, whatever. And he doesn't have counter attack, what the fuck am I talking? Don't ping here. Let's try charisma. Привет. Маленькая девочка. Where's another one of those? Bot face bashing, okay. Okay, one of the motor strikes has to hit. Alright, good enough. Oh, crap. Let's get them several. I could have played Stormhammer, but I wanted to develop the second Servo arm. Let's try with Stormhammer now. Classic. Hand out, everybody looking at me for a hand. Let myself on fire to hot wire. My entire life has led to where I am now. Yeah. Just some real shit. Would have had lethal anyway. But still. Oh, come here. Oh, shit. Alright, 14 points to go.
Saving mankind from the darkness is no weakness.
Kelbor, holy crap. We know what's it gonna be. A Sabotage is a really good card here. I actually also like Bargus, because I can play it after belting.
You are not so scary.
There's no turning back.
A crack. Could not kill it. Yeah, I have to do it probably. Because he has already two Mechandrites in his hand. I'm a bit afraid of that. Means I can't play Bargus, but I don't think it's that important here. Alright, let's belt. Gonna keep this guy around. For more efficient trades, so he can face bash into it. Okay. I think at this point we can push some damage. I don't know what he's doing, to be honest. It's probably his cheesy game plan is working out that well. Oh, look at that! 12 damage! All Mechandroid's gone, holy crap, dude. I'm just gonna keep nuking this guy, to be honest. Astra to be. That's a bummer. But we should be fine. Like, they're setting up to turn lethal. Okay. Problem is, if I jam it, it's still Eclipse Astra is a huge gamble. If it kills that, I'm fucked. But I probably have to do it. Back to put in terms of I have to trade. So if he doesn't heal himself, I'm done. Show him the honor. Let's act like we won't fare. $4,000 with Cobble Hall, not bad. I think we're done here for now, right? Oh, even plays 14. I could push for another win, to be honest. To secure my spot a bit, so to say. Let's do it. Fail. Double belts, not what I'm looking for. I'm gonna keep the hammer here. It's pretty important in this matchup, I think.
You are not so scary.
I hope he doesn't belt
you
turn
chose
one.
The wrong side.
Reserves. Well, that's just as bad. Well, what's up? Okay. That's gonna do anything here. We got full of Cardinal. So if he spams the board, I can clear it. I have a better play. I could eat some damage here and just equip the Karpus, but how good is Karpus here in this matchup? I'm just gonna go for it actually. Whatever. Don't think too much, boys. Yeah, that's a bummer. Goes aggressive. Yeah, bad pings. I would have wished to ping that. But that's life. He's no bullshit. So bad things, man. The problem is, if he pulled a nuke, I'm done. I'm just gonna go with the hammer here. Like, I don't want to risk anything. He had crucial choice. If that's some kind of, I don't know, capital ship, you're done. Yeah, I don't care about that.
wasn't a capital ship. He still goes face, okay. Year one. No. But, well, I guess. No, is it lethal? No, it's not. Holy crap, I'm 1 man off. Yeah, that's lethal though. I'm lucky today, holy crap.
My duty ends.
That's how you climb ladder, boys. Easy. So I think, that's enough for today. Rank 14. I think I'm gonna push top 10 like in the last week. Or tried. It's 80 points right now. So 74 points. Basically 75 points. I don't think it's worth it. Push that right now, I'm a bit drunk. And yeah, I don't know. I don't feel like doing that right now. Not in the mood, you know what I mean? So if anyone's up, we can do some more video games against random bullshit, random decks or something like that. Just send me a challenge like during the podcast, we had a ton of those. Otherwise, I'm gonna call it a day, I think. I still need to finish my challenge though. Oh man, what do I play for that? I hate this challenge. 7 attack. Like, if I think about it, I don't have any reliable, like here maybe? I got 1, 2, 3, 4 troops of 7 attack. That's not working, that's not... Oh, here, maybe Robert. I want... yeah, Robert might work. It's a luxury robot. Let's give him a go. They can practice. Also, if you're gonna send me a challenge, just write in chat. And then I'm gonna play against you. It doesn't progress the challenge, but I think it's more fun than playing practice games. Nave, we get enough matches today. Maybe someone else volunteers. Yeah, well, let's go. Hey, Yoda, eh? No, no, you don't. Ours is the better way. No sniper Reno.
I can't believe I had it.
Well, that sucks. Every never silent with the L's that I be lighting. Bitches think I'm Christ. How the fuck you giving life when he already fucking dead? Mentally unstable, fucking license. What I said as I said, is it right? If it's righteousness, it's fair. In their heads, heaven said, heaven said. Cop a couple O's as your rent. I'm a hole if you wanna talk percents. On the road, you can follow or get left. I bet followers upset. Take your follows off a set. Or I swallow your cassette. Little tape or whatever. Getting paid off of whether I display. Got a better, she was playing like the weather. Guess the change got a wetter. Or the rain came to settle with the flames. Never level with this work. Devil in the works. God with the words. Never settle for the first. I wish I had the money. I wish I had the money just to get the fuck out. I wish I had the money. I wish I had the money just to get the fuck out. Where do we go? Where to now? Where do we go?
Smurf.
Down for my squad, no one else. Don't tell me that you feel me. This is a town full of frauds, nothing felt. When they thought it was swell, I was pops with the belt. Had them drops on my shelf, it was hard not to smell. Fell hard, never fell. Success is in my blood. Who you calling? Who the flood? You should probably keep that mouth shut. Or get ran up on by us in the moment like a rush. For the potent, I might bust.
That's a bummer. I'm gonna play control for now. I'm also a bit sad that I didn't draw any of the bigger starters from Logos. Fine, let's give him that, I guess. Cards drawn. Here come the seals. I'm one energy off Stormhammer. We'll have to try. Easy. Was my only out? Fucking Michelle. Sorry, forgot to pass a turn. Oh, that's good. Let's play practice again. If anyone else wants, just let me know in the chat. Not know what. Meat's doing. My meat sounds wrong. Ah, yeah, soon I can make it. Борет не для тебя. Это моё мяско. Давайте по косточке. Молодцы собачки. Вот, вот эти вам. Все. Вот так вот. Dogs got some treats. Some entertainment from them as well. Здорово, Арвикан! Здорово! Yeah, goodbye, Nate.
Try to skip to my loo, but a dad's with a bars, with a coke, with a shrooms, but a bang, but a boom, skrr, vroom. on your hoes when I pass by. Got drugs by a landslide. Can't lie, bitch, I'm mad high. Kinda look like a bad guy. Girl like a vampire. Bitch like a campfire. Bitch, I don't like liars. Drugs till I'm hella tired. Depends which ones, but they also fun. And the meth and the harm for the dumb dumb dums.
No one in practice. Fuck that, you shouldn't be fucking with that. God damn, I really hate these challenges with put in place 7 attack units or 9 attack troops. Jesus Christ. It was kinda easy when Desperate Defense was around. Because it kinda counted towards the challenge if you pulled them off Desperate Defense. But right now it's such a chore, and there's actually no point in me doing them. Because I got all the cards but one, Dragneon. But I kinda have like OCD. You know, I really want to do these challenges, I want to finish them. Be it a chore or not. Да, я русский, но я в Германии живу. Из этого фильм на немецком. На английском. Come on, play practice. Anyone. I need to finish this goddamn challenge. Yes! Grey Fox! It's Grey Fox!
Weatherproofing America with vital there can be no justice without fear! That is not enough! Justice needs mercy!
What the fuck was this voice line? It sounded so girly.
Accept my greeting. Good to see you.
We all go through a lot of difficult things. Just remember that.
I would never play Specious Curse, no matter the matchup. Except if you had a Vengeful Spirit or something like we had before. Let's shoot back. I want to get the hero alongside with something else. Was that the mistake? Oh no, I'm at 8. Should be fine. It's so hard trying to keep some cash in. Now I'm sending eyes out of all the rich. Marcus. I think this is more sticky than last rifle. I was choked because I was so surprised. Yeah. I can't deal with 9 health right now, do I? 2, 4, 5, 8. I actually could. But in the process, everything I play dies. Let's do that.
Get a place out in the forest on the porch. So my cab is smoking dope.
should have cleared it. Problem is, this gets super huge. So I have to put it to 4, yes. Blank. Yeah, that's it, I guess. I'm playing with my other stuff. It's fine. Yeah, I'm gonna take 11 here. Ouchers! Why does he play that? None of my business why he plays that, to be honest. Goal against Curse is probably just to let him kill my stuff and get Reckoning. Oh. Yeah, I will keep that. Nostramo. Damn it. Oh, does it work? No, it doesn't. Kill that. Oh, I can. I have 11 energy. Probably should have killed Zulane over that, but whatever. Thing is, he's gonna kill Katsuhiro now. And I'm really bad at maths. Oh, holy crap, what is this shit? You get enough? You get another fucking... Another Nostramo from Kaiser Lane. So what's that? Probably Raven drawn, right? No. Well, that's GG nonetheless.
Death is nothing compared to vindication.
Two big board. 15. Oh man, you know what? Fuck this goddamn challenge. Maybe if I have maybe if the spirits, I'm gonna finish it today, maybe. I'm gonna even play bots or something, I don't know. But right now, no. Fuck that, I'm too tired. Like, focusing on the podcast, chat, and game at once was like a bit exhausting, to be honest. So right now, I'm gonna make some food and chill out a bit. Thanks for tuning in. For those who stayed through the whole podcast and then the viewer games, which was really fun. And let's see when we repeat that. During the weekdays, it's a bit of hard, but maybe next weekend. So, I'll hopefully see you then. See ya.